With a wonderful call, Krishna beckoned the cows to drink water. And with a signal from his flute, he called them all together. After making the cows sit in comfortable places, he and his elder brother played in the water with the two of them and with his other friends. Sanatana Goswami explains that the two of them are Swarupa and Jana Sharma. Sometimes, as his friends splashed water, Krishna defeated them with splashes. And sometimes the Lord, who is expert at playing, enjoyed his own defeat, making delightful splashing sounds and swimming sometimes with and sometimes against Sri Yamuna's currents. He enjoyed many wonderful pastimes. At times, submerging his body in the dark waters of the Yamuna and placing his face in a forest of blue lotuses, playful Krishna hid, unseen by anyone. Sanatana Goswami explains that Krishna's body was hidden by the dark water and his face was unrecognizable amongst the blue lotuses. Searching and not finding him, his grief-stricken friends wept terribly. Laughing as he emerged from the forest of lotuses, happy Krishna played with his friends, their eyes wide with a flood of happiness. He decorated them with water flower garlands strung on lotus stems, and they also decorated him. Then they emerged from the water. To enjoy lunch, he had the gopis make many circles on the broad shores of the Yamuna, and he placed his elder brother in the middle. Sanatana Goswami explains that this is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam 10.12.1. Wonderfully going here and there among them, as if playfully dancing, Krishna enjoyed serving them the many wonderful foods they had brought from home. Then he served them, as they wished, the fruits they playfully gathered from the splendid Vrindavan trees, which always bear the fruits and flowers of every season. He served them mangoes, tal fruits, bilvas, badaras, amalaki, coconuts, panasas, grapes, bananas, nagarungas, kariras, karjuras, pomegranates, and other sweet, ripe fruits. To please them, he took a little from each one. Sitting next to each person, the infallible Lord both fed and ate. Sanatana Goswami explains that Krishna sat next to each boy, and each boy thought that Krishna was sitting next to him only. Tasting everything and deciding which was the most delicious, each boy would respectfully offer it to Krishna, praising it and placing it with his own hands into Krishna's mouth. Tasting the delicious food, joking, and making funny faces, Krishna charmed them and made everyone laugh. Drinking and giving them to drink many kinds of bitter and sweet nectar drinks, and Yamuna water in gourd cups, the Lord, who is expert at enjoying many kinds of happy pastimes, pleased all the gopis. Then he chewed fragrant betel nuts mixed with camphor brought from home, and he also chewed betel nuts and betel leaves found in the forest. He took and distributed the wonderful garlands his friends made of tulsi, malati, jati, malika, kunda, kubjaka, lavanga, ketaki, jinti, karavira, the two kinds of satapatri, palasa, navamali, odra, damanaka, kadamba, nipa, bakula, naga, punaga, champak, kutaja, ashok, mandara, karnikara, asan, arjuna, patala, priyaka, and many other flowers and leaves. Sanatana Goswami explains that the two kinds of yutikas are the white and golden ones, and the two kinds of karaviras and satapatris are the white and the red kind. Then he anointed his limbs with the powder made from sandal, aguru, musk, kumkum, and other fragrant things brought from the forest. Sanatana Goswami explains that the boys crushed these things with stones and then made a paste with some water. In a beautiful forest grove, scented with fragrant flowers and pleasant with humming bees, on an excellent bed made of new soft leaves and flowers, served by boys who are expert in combing and decorating his hair, singing, massaging his lotus hands and feet, reciting prayers and fanning him, and his soft pillow, the body of a dear friend named Sridham, the Lord slept. Sanatana Goswami explains that this is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, 10, 15, 16, and 10, 15, 18. With hundreds of different playful and funny expressions on his lotus face, he won over the discriminating audience of his friends, expert in comedy, and made them all very happy. In this way, he and Balaram enjoyed many pastimes. By sounding signals on his flute and horn, making the cows stand up and walk, he enjoyed pastimes near Govardhan Hill. Each boy eagerly claiming, "I am the first!" With wonderful and colorful forest ornaments, they decorated him according to his own wish. Sanatana Goswami gives Haritala Tilak, a peacock feather crown, and a Gunja necklace as examples of these forest ornaments. Then, placing the newcomer, the Brahmin now named Jana Sharma, in Swarup's hand, Krishna, who gives happiness to Brhad, enjoyed the pastimes of entering the Gopa village in the evening. Sri Parikit concluded, "O Mata, by Lord Gopinath's mercy, you have become a great saint. Reflecting on the various aspects of this story, please accept this answer to your questions. Please try with great effort to go to Sri Goloka, which is a deep ocean of the greatest transcendental bliss. Simply by going there, one is able to enjoy many sublimely sweet and blissful pastimes with the Lord. These pastimes are not always manifest to one who simply goes to Mathura Mandala on the earth. However, they will be manifest to one who is flooded with the mercy of a devotee dear to the Lord. Therefore, O Mother, please take the dust of they who are dear to the Lord." By describing Goloka, which brings eternal love for the Lord's glorious lotus feet, touched by the glory of the kumkum of the gopis' breasts, I have answered your sweet and profound questions and have dispelled your doubts. Far above Vaikuntha, Goloka is splendidly manifest. It is attained only by a flood of love for the feet of the gopis' handsome lover. It gives a result beyond what one can desire. It gives a treasure of spiritual love to they who meditate upon it. Now, please hear the words of the great sages describing this, words that will please your heart. The following texts are taken from Indra's prayers to Lord Krishna in the Hari Vamsa. Above Svargaloka is Brahmaloka, where Brahma and the sages reside. Also, there is the abode of Lord Shiva and the abode of the effulgent liberated souls. O Krishna, your splendid realm of Vaikuntha is very great, but far above it is Goloka, the splendid realm of the cows, where great souls go. Although we have all asked Grandfather Brahma about it, none of us know any place above Goloka. Svargaloka is the realm of virtuous persons who are peaceful and self-controlled and have performed pious deeds. Brahmaloka is the realm of they who have performed spiritual austerities. Goloka is far above them. O Krishna, O saintly one, you personally stay in Goloka and protect everyone from all calamities. Sanatana Goswami explains that in this context, the word Brahmaloka means Vaikunthaloka. Lord Krishna speaks this verse to Arjuna in the Skanda Purana. O son of Kunti, in many different forms I wander in the material world, in the spiritual world, and in the eternal realm of Goloka. Sri Janamejaya said, O best of Vaishnavas, I had heard these verses before from Vaisampayana, but now that I hear them from you, a new understanding shines in my heart. Oh, the glory of devotees is very wonderful. Sanatana Goswami explains that the verses referred to are the quotations from Harivamsa just spoken. Fearing that this description will now end, my heart is becoming unhappy. Please, give some more nectar, so it will remain happy. Jaimini Rishi answered, O child, happy to hear the description of Goloka's glories, with wonderful and sweet love, your father sang many verses from two stories to confirm these descriptions. Beautiful verses that are the essence of the Shruti and Smriti. I wander in this material world speaking these verses. In this way, I become freed from the unhappiness of separation from your father. Sanatana Goswami explains that the two stories are Brahma Sanhita and the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, which are both quoted in the following verses.